Welcome to Module 8. In this module, we're going to talk all about budgeting. Budgeting is useful for a business because it explains how they're going to use their limited resources. But something I didn't appreciate as a student is just how applicable budgeting is to a student, a non-accountant, right? You don't have to be a company's accountant to need to budget and to benefit from a budget. And looking back to my college days, I remember there were weeks where I didn't have very much money and I had to plan very explicitly on what food I would buy and what food I would not be able to buy at the supermarket. And I thought a terrific budgeting exercise would be to use $25 and see how I would survive the week. $25 Canadian, which is at today's rates around, you know, less than $20 US. See if I could survive the week on that kind of money. And so I, you know, certainly did this as a practical matter when I was a college age person, but now as a later in my career, I'm going to do it as an exercise to see if I can pull it off. Can I survive on $25 a week? Well, let's see. Let's see how well I'd survive. Of course I could, but how well will I survive? So I just went to my supermarket website. They have online shopping. And the first thing I bought was a dozen eggs. I think eggs are a great way, you know, 2 eggs a day, basically. And that's a pretty good breakfast in terms of lots of protein. It's a very filling thing to have in the morning. And I can just eat eggs as they are. I'm happy to eat eggs with a little salt and pepper. And that would be a good breakfast. So we're at $3. And this will be a running total here. I'm rounding a little bit here. I would like to have some bread. I don't even know if bread is a good thing to buy when you're on a budget because I always seem to get hungrier when I eat carbs, but I would buy some bread. And again, I'm assuming I have like margarine in the fridge. Maybe I don't. Maybe I have to buy margarine. I didn't do it for this exercise. So my running total is right around $5 after having the eggs and the bread, a little less than that. Jasmine rice, I would buy rice. I do think this would be a reasonable supply. In the real world, I would buy a much larger supply of rice and hope it lasted me longer. I don't tend to buy rice in 750 gram increments. I buy larger rice. But, you know, if this is the exercise and my cupboards are bare, $3 worth of rice should be a lot of rice to help sustain me. I need greens. I'm not a great eater, but spinach is a relatively good green for value for money. So I'm up to $12 here. It's, you know, I'm halfway there. I don't have a lot of protein on my plate. That's sort of the concern at this point. I would buy some filler type stuff. So like 8 ramen noodles for $2.50. I'm going to round this one down because I've been rounding a lot of the previous ones up. Let's just say I'm right around $14 coming off of that. I would also buy a good Canadian loves Kraft dinner, and I love Kraft dinner. Again, I'm assuming I have margarine. I don't need milk to eat Kraft dinner, but I do need some margarine. It's $1 each. Let's buy 6 of them to bring me up to $20. And last but not least, I need some protein. And you can see the chicken's eyes here are $7. That brings me up to 27. And I would at this point say, oops, I've blown the budget. Something's gotta give, right? The easiest thing to give would be, I'm not gonna take 6 macaronis. I'm only gonna take 4. If I have $4 worth of macaroni, that brings me up from 14 to 18. And this brings me from 27 down to 25. Now, I could also, you know, if I had to deal with tax, maybe I'd go down to 3 macaronis. I think at that point, it's not a balanced diet, but I'm certainly surviving. I'm not living large, but I'm certainly surviving. But that's how budgeting works. You're planning ahead. You're hoping for your company's survival. You're trying to use the company's resources appropriately. And you're just projecting ahead. What is our company going to need? And what do we have to satisfy those needs? That's it. It's just a simple planning ahead exercise. I wonder, what do you think of my diet? What should I be getting? Maybe beans? Would beans be better? How do you stretch a dollar when you have to stretch a dollar? I'm an old, out-of-touch, tenured faculty member, so it's been a long time since I've gone to the grocery store and thought, I'm going to buy the no-name ramen noodles. I buy fancy imported ramen noodles that cost like $1 each, so I'm a pretty hoity-toity kind of a guy now. What would you buy, though? I wonder if you would do better than me and live better than I would on a frugal budget. All right, that's all for this video. In this whole series of videos, we're going to learn tons of different kinds of budgets. Bye for now.